Hello everybody, it's Mac here, and today we're going to have the first episode of my new series called GTA 5 Gun Guide. And in this episode, we're going to be reviewing the pistol. Now, the pistol is a weapon in Grand Theft Auto 5 and Grand Theft Auto Online, and it is the first weapon in the pistol category in GTA 5. So the pistol is unlocked after beating the mission Franklin and Lamar in the single player, and it is given you by Lamar in online. So once you load into online, it will be given to you. Now we're going to be going through the stats of this pistol, and in game it has a damage of 2.6 out of 10, a fire rate of 180 rounds per minute whenever it's fired just holding down the trigger. Now if you actually tap in the weapon, it will actually be faster than that at 240 rounds per minute if you can actually get up to that, which could be kind of hard if you don't have the best trigger finger. Now, whenever you're doing a drive-by shooting, whenever you're shooting from your car or a vehicle, it will vary between 140 and 150 rounds per minute. We'll just assume that this is for frames. The accuracy on the pistol is 4.0 out of 10, and the range on the pistol is 2.5 out of 10. The magazine size is 12 rounds or 16 with extended clip, which you can put extended clip on this weapon. And this weapon is a decent starting weapon, and because you do get this for free in online, and you get it in single player pretty early on. Now, it's more of a standard weapon. It's not the best weapon, and you could see that in the gameplay. It's not all too great. Now, if you look at the weapon stats on another player, and big thanks to a person on Xbox that goes by the name of PvP Eclipse, he helped me out with this stats with this weapon on against other players, and he was level 62. So expect this to be a little higher or a little lower, depending on the rank of your enemy that you are shooting at. But against another player, it will be a one-hit kill to the head. The chest will be 12 shots, the leg will be 7 shots, and the arm will be 14 shots. Now, if the enemy has a bulletproof helmet on, it will take 5 shots to the head with a bulletproof helmet. And at a long distance, as you can see right here, this will actually be 23 shots. So, up close, it will vary from about 12 to 14 shots, which is about a clip. But if you get that headshot, then that will only be one hit kill, unless they have a bulletproof helmet. So, if you're at a long distance, it can take you almost up to 2 clips. Now, the reload time on this weapon isn't that bad. It's pretty fast, especially with extended clip. Now, this weapon is also a unique weapon. If you equip it without a suppressor, you can actually commit suicide with this weapon. You'll hold up the weapon to your head and shoot. That's if you hold down the interaction menu, go to the bottom, and it will say kill yourself. You can do that. If you have a suppressor on this weapon, or you don't have this weapon at all, yeah, it won't have that animation. You'll just die. And there are a few things about this weapon that are kind of unique. One is that in-game, it's listed as a 45 ACP pistol, while the PT92 in reality actually fires a 9mm Parabellum round. Now, this weapon is a good alternative to the pistols in the game, but it's not that great. Honestly, in my opinion, and this is just my opinion on this weapon, after you start ranking up, maybe rank 10 to rank 20, you shouldn't really be using this weapon all that often. You'll get way better pistols early on, you'll get way better weapons early on, and this weapon just falls behind. It's not all that great, and we'll be talking about new pistols and other weapons that you unlock in this series. Now, there is one thing that's good about this weapon, and that's in survivals. It can be used pretty well in survivals, because it will actually be a 1 to 2 hit kill early on in survivals, until about wave 3 or 4, but after then, once they call in vehicles and choppers and stuff, you're not really gonna want to be using this weapon in survivals. It's also a pretty bad weapon for gang attacks, especially if you're a high rank, because they'll start once you get a high rank, they'll have miniguns and heavy weapons, and you don't want that. You don't want to have to deal with that. Now, one of the redeeming factors of this weapon is that it is a one-hit kill to the head, but most weapons are that way. Unless an enemy is using a bulletproof helmet, you will actually get a one-hit kill headshot. But with the rate of fire that it has, it's not all that great to go around just with this weapon, just hoping for a headshot. But it is a okay weapon if you are running out of ammo on your assault rifle, your MG, and you want a good alternative, and if you're running low on ammo of all of your other weapons, if you can get that headshot, then you will be doing pretty well. And it is a okay starting weapon, but even then, once you start ranking up, you're not going to want to be using this weapon at all, really. Now, the iron sights on this weapon aren't that bad, actually. They are okay, but the rear sights kind of obstruct your view. The green on the pistol on the iron sights are okay, but you're still not going to be doing the best with these iron sights in first person mode. But that's just my opinion on this weapon. Let me know what you think about this weapon in GTA 5. Do you like the pistol? I mean, honestly, I don't really like it. It just gets outclassed by a lot of other weapons. So let me know what you think about this weapon in the comments. Next episode of this series will be on the combat pistol in GTA 5. And we'll be talking about that weapon. So now I'm going to be talking about this series on my channel. And what we're going to be doing with this series is we're going to be going through every weapon in GTA 5. We're going to be going through every single weapon until we get to them all. Now we're going to be going through the weapon wheel. Is we going through the pistols, then the MGs, then the assault rifles, then the snipers, then the shotguns, then the heavy weapons, then the throwables, then maybe the melee weapons. We'll also be going through some attachments and some other things in the game. And I'll probably make these episodes every other day, so they'll probably be going up every other day. I don't want to spam you guys with this series, and I want to also be making other content, and not just this series, but I will be doing this series quite often in GTA 5. So if you like this series and you want to see some more of it, then let me know in the comments and let me know what you think of the pistol in GTA 5. So hope you enjoy. Feedback is always appreciated, and I'll see you guys in the next video.